What is that? Underwater. Hell yeah. Okay, so you just have to dump this into the dev folder. Yeah, I have internet issues. Bunch of them. Like when we play Battlefield, I have to connect to another router just to get it to play because of that collisions, I guess. Like it won't let us both join on the same squad and use voice over IP in a game. It's a lot of fun. The thing I love about it though is that you can still fix it by just get one of those old routers, but since we didn't have one, I use my phone as one, but it requires that app. What's it called? To show how it's supposed to look when it's installed and find the name. Yeah, so I go and change my network settings to that, the BDA Net app. There's another name for it, a Fox something. It's $10 or $8, depending on which version you want. And it'll just turn your phone into a Wi-Fi or a USB to Ethernet type thing. Not Ethernet, but yeah, it'll send your computer through that thing, through the USB cord, like an Ethernet connection routed again from your modem router. It's nice because I could play Battlefield now with my little brother. My sacrifice is about 10 ping for being on wireless connection. But it's nice because the device is very small. Doesn't use a lot of power. And hopefully it prevents it from ringing. Son of a bitch. There's some world UI shader thing in this. Always a catch. That's catch I didn't want to go through. Yeah. It only takes a day. No, it takes half a day, but we'll do it. We don't set the build right now, I don't care. Then I'll just try to edit this that it's building. I believe I could be in the editor if I set my bootstrap. What? Gigs? Oh yeah, this was 1 gig. So it extracts about 3 or 2. Guess that's good though. It's a cool project. Oh, it's so big. Whatever. You just have to get more storage. Okay. Did some cheap cool graphics. Nice. Broadcast, world UI, player events, auto weapon fire. Alright, so I'll install that. Just name this 6/26/2019. It'll be very dry and boring. Most drawing as boring as possible. On purpose. Did it deliberately. For the sake of revenge and evil. I'll use my other green terrain thing. Now, what if I wanted to mod that terrain thing? Because the first thing I'm gonna work on is terrain anyway, so I might as well get into it really nicely. 4 squares from that will be our hole. I don't know. That wasn't what I wanted to get started with, but it's sometimes interesting to just go into like play mode. Oh, I'm making a map for Yes. Because essentially, this is how you make the maps in CS now. You can actually make it in here. So, well, the problem is the terrain and source is a certain way. It's not bad. And it is bad. Because they source coded it to be into the engine or something. Maybe they didn't. The displacements or nobody ever touches that code. And because there's no editor, if you edit that, you don't have source code for editor. The next thing that you kind of talk about is editors, I guess. And I guess the Lumberyard editor doesn't run on Mac, for sure, for certain. I mean, you can get it to run if you have the source code to compile it, and that's, do we have the source code in Windows? Let's go check that out. I don't have the answer yet. We do compile it though, so when we go to folder, I built both Visual Studio 17 and 15 common libraries. Okay. Oh, that's where I was like, my question was, it's actually, yeah. Okay, so I'll just finish up on this. It just gives the map some difference for when I edit some layers, stupid stuff. 'Cause I want it to be gray. I want it to be 128, 128, 128 gray, because it is the center color. It has to be artistically, physics-wise, very dry. Because then, if you build on top very boring things, it makes it really interesting in the end. You put everything together, if they're all boring combined. The map can be reused generically, it looks good, but there's no bells and whistles anywhere. So it makes it, like, legit. Sort of like the boring old statue. It's boring, it's old, but it's there forever for some reason. The reasoning is it's just so gray and boring. It's like that middle of everything. Like rock. Just like hard to destroy, hard to move. You can't take it really to the dump. It's hard to destroy and move. That's why I have inmates destroy rocks. Rocks. God, I'm gonna use a rock. Okay. Yeah, for the waste business, there is. It's funny. Because it's cheaper to throw a lot of things away. Especially if they're lighter. And then, yeah, recycling. We have dump of ocean on our planet. I mean, islands. Plastic. Should make the rich people embarrassed. I don't know. It doesn't work though, that causes more problems for everyone. Of course, it causes more problems for the people that have nothing to do with it. We need train editor, yeah. Train tool. I tried that. I don't want to use the layer painter. I mean, I don't want to paint the color like I did in the last video thing. So that's just very unprofessional or something. Well, this is our terrain. Why is it in gray in the editor? Did we do something stupid like use fill? Set five of these layers up. Maybe even six. Is 124 the max height? Let's go check after I fill this out. That's always the funnest, like reading, debugging while you just didn't finish anything. And then you're just like debugging small things all day. That's like the best strategy because it's a splat mat path. Probably something I'm supposed to set. Oh, so our default texture is set to this. We have to set it to white. Yeah, 255, 255, 255, 255 for alpha, green, RGB, blue, city color red. Yeah, it's always good to mention red last because if you're like me, you memorize it first, RGB. So that's always easier. Memorize green, blue. So when you memorize the colors in like electronics for resistors, it's good to do it when you're young. So then it's easier to reconfigure everything later. Like, oh, it means the color means a number, and then the other number means this. Oh, it's such a ghetto way of doing it, but it saves so much resources. It's every little component on your computer has to have these like certain things written on them. Okay, so we're surrounded by terrain in two different areas. It's kind of cool. But my stupid mission isn't accomplished. I hate loading the projects in Visual Studio because it lags. And it kills your hard drive for no reason. So let's just check if we can compile and edit the editor because I want to be able to edit the flow graph and cloud canvas stuff. I'm able to see what it does before I run certain things. Make sure I don't do anything unnecessary. The theory is to run a Linux box to make it faster and more efficient. The computer has to be less performance, but gives more performance. With all that, my conspiracy belief is that Amazon is trying to use their little grid-made system to just monopolize us into using their net thing. Whereas why don't we just take our old computer or phone and turn it into a Linux box. Make it an 8-player server for free instead. Yeah, it's gonna be a hard one. Because all the developers are gonna wanna do it, but Amazon's not. Well, what happened with MalVision is the hackers just wrote side-by-side engines of their source code they didn't release after they decompiled it. And engine failures. My guess is you go download some rebuilt version of CSGO or something. And there's some very crazy people that would so he makes the diffuse material a variable? Nice. Then the editor, yeah, because there's certain things that you need to be variabilized in the editor like this, like bindings. How do you switch bindings in Lumberyard and Source Engine? It's sort of automatic. It's sort of a assumed feature. So you have a key bindings dot list file and you just mod that and then you can add like a tag 2 and a few more bindings on top of what the engine already has, Or you could just rebind them and rename them. It's always nice to just certain keys will do certain like priority things for certain keys or gameplay. Certain keys are not gameplay, so those classes have like different layers on in the engine. So you can press a key, it can interact with the game in a root UI, or it's interacting within HUD UI. And what if main menu is loaded? Or you're in the main menu, you're not displaying HUD UI, but you press a key that affects HUD UI, like scoreboard. So when you think back to like making the game from scratch, most people don't implement it that crazy. They just one key released, key pressed loop. That's usually how it's done. But in the bigger games, it's just passed into subclasses, and they all the classes that have to get it during that time get it. So it doesn't just send it to the HUD UI; it just ignores. If I wanted to migrate 18, oh, I already did. Oops. I'm talking about void stuff. Something simple like terrain layer. Yes. I was hoping this was gonna happen. And the sun is like hell with the white background. This guy got 3.6k views, so everybody knows this.
Feedback in the viewport. Height. Same goes hit the roof.
I want layers though.
Not be able to go below the terrain. In my case, I can go below the
terrain. Yeah, I should add an ocean. But I do want to make my layers. I messed with my other layer though. My other. Is that the main problem? This is the main problem. Because it's like whatever. So, what do we add? A lot of the terrain. We could use a shader, I think, and parallax localization mapping. Use that to, it'll make it like crazy 3D texture. Or particle effect. And or. Should we actually do both at the same time, but we'll keep this as terrain shader, just make it red. It's like if you dig through the ground, you should be able to see red. Maybe it won't be like swamp, but it'll be magma, fake magma. Be a better color. I don't like the words white and black. I like the words FFFFFF and 0000. And I don't like the words default because it's long. Renaming in this is a little unconventional because of how they use the files, but I understand that it's important to do it like this. Or preaching to their cause, I guess. It's the color hex. I can get the hex value of that, but that's hex value of 85. So 05500. So we could do that. We could put certain parameters of our texture stuff into their file name so we kind of understand what it does and means. TN terrain. Material type, so shader name, it's material, kind of what our project cause is, and what type it is, default, so it's like an alpha or special or new, and then the color. Not gray, let's do gray tint. My other project's gonna be affected by this. That's what I kinda don't like. It's how do you set up different terrain parameters, different levels or something? 127 or 128, which is the real between value of 255? It's 27.5. No, okay. I think. Is it that? What if you put 128, 80? I use 127 just because it's lighter. I think it's wrong. But it tells me hex values in here, so I don't have to open Photoshop like a crazy person. Waste 2 gigs in RAM, or maybe it's 512, but in megabytes. MB. DOS commands in my head to make this funnier. Oh, so if I click here, oh, it tells me I already knew that. I figured that out using the calculator. Oh, all my calculator skills gone to waste. See, we'll have a yellow, brown, one of the other default colors. I guess when you get a few of them in here, it starts getting easier. It's kind of, that was like the biggest thing when I started this. I never organized these terrain materials. I did have some because it's kind of really cool. When I spend time. You don't want to spend time in terrain settings. But for like making maps like Battlefield, this is probably like, yeah, if you get your tiling, cool.
What part are you in the single player?
Yeah. No.
Anyone hears my mic?
Maybe.
Hello? Hello?
Lenny.
What?
Not far.
What part were you on? Northeast thing?
It's second gate. Second.
It's like you're going to a big building on
Maybe not. I was trying to get through the gates on the hills.
Beginning?
It's like, you know when you get the silenced pistol? Did you get to that part? Where the flamethrower guys were?
No, yeah, I got the science pistol before, I think. So I look around in all the crates, like, looking for them. Wait, so you didn't get to the big facility yet, or you're already past it?
Facility.
Wait, look at my screen. The door's the only way to figure out it.
Okay. Hold up. Some colors that are like standard colors for the standard of LY, whatever the TV standards are. Have to kind of use some of them for that great purpose. Time for destruction of the terrain. Yeah, terrain is really cool because if I could have two terrains, physics, and then you can modify the terrains, two terrains would be sufficient for some cool tricks about having underground layers or making terrain that's beyond the Y point or something. What I meant by that is making like a cliffhanger situation where can I save all somehow? I'm just gonna use save and then basically I wanted to load hammer and show an example, basically cliff terrain. The thing is, the other thing about terrain is, yeah, climbing for the first person code. Oh, this looks cool. Yes. Kill it. Kill it. Yes. Make a tree out of it. I mean, build a house. Destroy the environment. And dump 3D game. Oh, cool. It's like a physics thing. Anyway, answers her question of no. Stupid game. Oh, cool. Whoever made this was taking their time. Creating high quality terrain. Thing I don't like about the mega texture? Total resolution 16 times 16K. What what was that equal in megabytes or whatever? Can I copy this? It's always like mysterious how that copy works. Times. Yeah, so you're getting a quarter of a gig in this particular example. Let's see if we can open this texture in GIMP. Okay. Change layer texture. Material library. Physical material library. Pick physics material. I need some physics materials. I'll get some. Okay. Just do. Let's close that. No. I think I'm dumb. I'm supposed to hit this, select that in here, then hit assign material. Yes, I figured it out. I'm a brilliant scientist, a dumb that used to know how to do it, and then died. So my brain cells died, and now I'm back to life. Sorry. I had to insult myself just to make myself happier. About something. That I could do this quickly and efficiently, like a human being, like I thought I was going to from the very beginning. But a life sentenced me to a lot of torture. And it's their fault. Alright, so I like the way this is going. Is this the mega texture part? Fuck. Okay. Nice. Except I'm kind of not prepared for this. In terms of, I wanted to do it like this. It's close. I want to go. Right. Game terrain. happy with this resolution because it means very good things for phone performance. My guess is you can make a map and edit it. We want to export this, name it, make a texture, level map underscore 626, the date dot level name or whatever level name is right here. Export, I guess. Okay, did we export? Let's go to our folder that we went to. And put it in GIMP. What if we do open it in Paint and blow up our memory buffer? That's what we get. It's not even 124. It is 124. But okay, per tile. Yeah, so fuck. on map, it could be acceptable to have this for the dwarf phone, but it's still kind of big. Could we just go back to 512 instead of 2K? The idea, I think, here is to be able to do that. Oh, I'm not sure. Whatever that did. Okay, it's like red over there now. Oh, it's all magma. And I could change the UV coordinate things too. Why is it always red? It's not supposed to be. nice of color red. This might be the problem. Save. Nice of color red. This might be the problem. Save. fuck. So, let's do that like that. For lava is fine. Okay. Go back. No, fuck. It's still right up here. What the hell? I'll die. Okay. Set the height to 50. Oh, it's raised and lower. Oh, website's created mountains. Save. But their colors should change. This is where, okay, it does. There is this layer. Or maybe it's the sky thing. It's giving me that fog. From far away, it's white. Close, it's red. Oh, here it's this color. It's, well, it is that bottom layer, but why is it not? Okay, what if I disable that layer or delete it? So max height. Layer size. What are spot maps? Okay, started messing more things up. It's still bad. Okay. Far away good, close up bad. I need to make it a mess of color go away, I think, too. Worked. Okay. And save. That's not the main thing. Terrain, edit terrain. Flatten side adaptation. Paint terrain layers. Well, I guess I have to paint them. Name them. some reason it's driving me nuts. I don't know why. Oh, it's because let's go battlefield. Okay. Save layer. Mask by. It's at the radius 25. Actually, I want it to be like 30 because it's divisible by 3 and 2. But 32 would be a mathematically hex number. Or 64. Not changing it though. Kind of worked, kind of didn't. Happens. It's part of the thing. Part of making the look. Okay. I know something like this might work. Then our sand layer. Let's go back. Right. So let's say the bottom of this thing is magma. We'll make it emissive red though. If we make it emissive red from far away. Next to this. Green? No. It's greener. It's gray, red. It's white. Yeah, that's a more sandy color. Dang, but it flips the problem. That's why I wanted to reset it by. So it doesn't get red anymore, right? Yeah, it doesn't. Okay, but can we do something like flood? Kind of don't want to do flood. But then, what else choice do I have? Of the redness. It feels so good. Then it feels really bad that is, we just need to do a little test. This slope thing I gotta mess around with later. For now I don't need to because it's waste more time. But this thing I wanted to do. Actually want it to be yellow also. Specular color. Yeah, the specular color is also weird on this one. Or messed up, but I decided to mess it up more. I think the problem is that I might need to make specular white or black though. Can I change this to like? Of like, it's more static, like, it's more redder. Opacity 100%, radius, density, brightness. This is the real interesting thing. Far. The color doesn't go away. And the other ones it does though. Figure out the shader for this later. So I can make the magma the ocean. Should I just shoot right now? Or paint this later? So like it could be this here. I'm guessing. Yeah, it's just adjusting the mixture of colors, I guess. Next thing would be like vegetation or something. it's no use for it unless they poke a hole through it and make a cave. Things I don't like about Infinite Ocean. It's that it's like cheap resort. It doesn't seem like it's on a planet, but it makes it an island sort of automatically. This was at 1. Want it to be really noticeable. Even if it takes screwing it up, making it look like death. Yeah, that would make cool lava. Maybe. If there was multiple noise functions somehow interacting. The other one was better. It's more pristine. Yeah, the speed makes this really. Oh, if the speed is 0, it's still scrolling. It looks like icicles. It looks like ice or something. Makes it really seem peaceful. Let's see, frame rate 126, right? Yeah, it affects the frame rate just by a few frames, but it still does. Okay, like this, it's 200, right? But still, though, it's different. It's not too much different, but I guess it's the eye detecting all the movement makes. Yeah, it makes the biggest difference to the person. Okay, that looks good. Okay, ocean default. Make this into a lava texture. Now I have to change the whatever terrain maybe to be higher. cool to add more assets into roads and the other spline type things. Stupid. Oh. It'd be cool to do the voids. Add all these things. Make a little rainforest. Go back to the material editor in a sec. Oh, I should just use find engine assets, materials, test, materials, water. Let's see. Okay, so shader is water. Surface type is water. Make the surface types lava, ice, ladder, invulnerable, flesh, fabric, concrete. Technically, it's like. It's like molten, so it doesn't really have it. Gen type 2D, how do we change the color then? Diffuse tint. I can't change the color in here. Don't change it, maybe in the shader thing. I'll save it, change it to the crazy custom one. Who cares? See what happens. Change the wrong one. It's supposed to. Yeah, it like won't run when it's supposed to run. So go. Okay. Okay. So. fixed up the terrain more. Get it to be a far away green thing working. What's the transition, right, to green? Some of these places. Yeah, like right here. But from far away, it's kind of like that. Save. Kind of like green with most of the color parameters. The other one that I could change was the actual texture. I could change it to be green by default inside the texture map. I could also modify specular to behave differently. That would make it interestinger to have them their default property shader behaviors, just like roaming around depending on layers and paints and stuff. Okay. Guess after green we could have rocks and cliffs and rocks and dirt under green and above green. You could just like, keep mixing the layers or something, or they could be both the same place too, or something, to make it also seem that the world is changing terrain places and different elevations. So what if we had all that running? far away. See it. And close up, it looks different. Cool. So we go like a green area here. The UV coordinate map thing is kind of important later on. It should be like the grass and everything should be part of vegetation, should be part of it's not, I don't want to do the gay old school way of making it part of the map. The map texture is the grass now. I mean, that looking green is not sort of like the grass, but we also have the coordinates so people could like see, oh, this far away from this object to this object. You could actually grid it. But then, the color painting, it's not this color painting, it's the layer thing. Also have these type of layers for sand and stuff. Yeah, so it's a little bit interesting. You go in and you see different. If I add vegetation and stuff, it'll make it even more interesting. But first off is to simply make that a little different. Yeah, so that looks. Just the color, the way it changed like that. The fact that you can see this like line, it's bad and it's good. There's a way to get rid of it too. But I don't want to get rid of it. I mean, this should have the clouds gem. Let's see if we can do it. Sky cloud. Where? There is a sky cloud. You are not in the right place, box shape. You have to go up here. Wrong position, I think. Oh man, my little island and whatever. Works at 100 frames per second. Four entities. Now we have clouds that. 500 or something. I have to move them by this thing. Okay. Guess the center of our map kind of. Why did it send me more back away? That shows me where the clouds are. That's how I know where the clouds are. Oh, that's one point of it. Okay, so this is one. Okay, let's start. Okay, that looks right. It looks like somewhere that we need to be. Where's our damn cloud? There will be someone, and they will say, the game that has clouds fucking sucks. But guess what? We want clouds now. Oh, I see them. Do you guys see them? Someone went in the water. It's actually good. Oh, fuck. That's how it looks like underwater? Sick. People are gonna die in here. The sun, the light coming down should be a little bit less intense underwater. I think I fucked that up somehow. I should have checked that while I was making the ocean settings before shader. That's okay. Now I have to like like the square box in the center of the screen. I gotta try it out like this. There we got a swamp. Stuff. I think I could use the sequencer to just make a camera fly around. Can't I? Alright, just do the whole move object thing first. Sprite blinding crap. I mean, clouds causes some funny results. Bad settings. Why do I type 50 and I get 6? I like that the clouds are low. It gives them a don't give a fuck. What was it initially? It was like 4. Some other parameter is making them look very good. There's no shape color, it doesn't show. It just shows the stupid dots. Okay, how do we get it not to be tiled like shit? Delete component. React component. Okay. Did it lose our size? must have. Maybe it didn't. Things look a little better. That's what flips it up. Rows and columns field. The rows and columns are the offsets for the thingamajiggers, because if you have them wrong, it's the offsets for the bitmap image or the PGN image. We call it a palette, or it's called various different things, and it's just where you kind of don't like how that follows me. Like when I'm like really close to the water, and this cloud is like, it seems that it's first person or third person. It's kind of good in a way, kind of not. Seems like it's moving, not with me. Or it's moving too much with me. It's part of me. Part of me is cloud. These clouds move with me. I don't know why. They block my view. I'm pissed off. Okay. Let's get rid of that view problem thing. Sort of gets rid of it, but destroys everything I made. My beautiful creation. Oh, of course. Now, this is what I wanted. A nuclear explosion. This is actually probably the good way to do this. Let's see. Oh, I can't just make it go away like an entity. Oh shit. This is where shit hell fuck. Yeah, there's too much of this ones that move with you and they really fuck you up. Them going through mesh blending thing. I know how I'm gonna do it. Go back to this. Fucking nuclear explosion. There is something to look at over there. Let's see how much of our problems is fixed. Some of it. Yeah, we don't have anything under us following us persistently. We got fucking killed. Okay, we blocked the view of the sun. Oh, that's nice. We don't have any glare anymore. Fuck yeah. I hate it in Battlefield when you look down the fucking scope. There's glare. You get killed by glare, not by the other player, not by. And he's hiding in bushes and everything, using everything around him, but you're getting killed by the sun glare. That's not fair. So this is a good fix for that. I don't know if we can get something cool out of this like this. And we can't see the stupid line anymore, kind of. And we can, but the clouds really get it out of the way. I like this. It's like a nuke happened. is the level I call roof. Oh, that's a little bad right here. That's not right. Colors changing. Cool. A little bit too many clouds through the... Let's go to the center of the map. Point of this wasn't the biggest map in the world. Nice. So when you look up, that's how the sun looks like in the middle of the map. And just a few little things. My only other setting that I wanted to kind of do is this. This is the max height of the terrain number. But we've just removed the clouds almost completely. Let's try it. Oh, 700 really kicks it. Yeah. It's 800. Just not enough. 750, probably asking for worse. 710. Just wanted to look kind of bright around here. There's no clouds now. I'm looking at it from like a RTS game. Building barracks here and stuff. And if it's 70 degrees, you start seeing clouds in your face. It's annoying. This. They're supposed to be high enough to where, like, oh, the game's over. Oh, cool. This place actually has clouds. It's not just super empty. So I'm going to set it to 7.4. 15. Actually, I want it to be 700, but whatever. I'm fighting over myself too much now. Let's see the editor. It's the GridMate network thing. Whatever it is. Game lift. This is. System events. Two renders for this, for Windows, I mean. We've got a GL render, Mac. I'm gonna have to check this out because I can't compile it for Metal 2.1. I mean 1.2. Well, we see 2.1 for Metal. Sorry. I think there's also one that's like that too. The editor. Resource editor icon. I want to modify this. Yeah, I want my editor icon to be fucking skull. There's a way to edit it in here. see, I just replace it and import it. 32 bits, 48 by 48. What? C file. Vehicle, are we talking about car vehicle? Some sort of editor vehicle weapon. To get a car vehicle. Can we make our undo size bigger? Undo size bigger. Up the window with QT library. Oh, piece of crap. Can't use it because it's not an extension file. Basically, it's like loads of library. There's also the script canvas thing. Other things appear in script canvas. Alright, gotta go make some tea though. Editor core API, that's C++. Damn it. So I guess this is the static pointer whole application. let's say I'm stupid. And I wanted to make a program to write the game automatically in the editor. So it would be a bot, kind of like a chat bot, would sit there and auto aim inside the editor. Tell it to make hills and stuff. And NPCs, I guess. Default spawn points. And export thousands of levels. Where HTTP requests will just spawn the items by database. Good test for everything. You gotta look at GC creator.